Good day, here's the sun. This video is part 3 of my FMAT series. So if you haven't checked out the first part and the second part of my FMAT series, please check it out after this video, especially the part 2. I guarantee that it's really helpful for your exam. Alright, so in this video, we'll go through some challenging questions as the last preparation before you enter the SPM exam hall. And for some of the questions, I will show you how to apply my answer checking method into the question, which is the reverse thinking method. I already explained this powerful answer checking method in details in part 2, so make sure you check it out. Alright, so don't forget to smash the like button below and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Let's get started. Alright, so we'll look into SPM trial question, and in this video, we'll go through 4 questions. So the first question here, this question is quite special. It's from SPM trial Sabah 2021. And why is it so special? Because in this question, we're required to find the direction and the time when two boats meet, and also the position vector when they meet. Alright, so let's look into this question. So diagram 4 shows the position vector of two boats A and B relative to the fixed point O are this and this. So position vector of A should be like this, and then position vector of B will be negative Q, negative 2. So now boat A move with a velocity of this, and boat B move with a velocity of this at the same time. Okay, so this is velocity A, which is 4 and P, and velocity B will be 3, negative 1. Okay, given boat A move with a speed of 5, find the value of P where P is less than 0. That means P is a negative value because it's less than 0, right? Since this is speed, so let's look at the velocity. So from this velocity, I can know that in 1 minute, boat A will move 4 units to the right and then P unit to downwards. Why I know P unit is to downwards? Because P is negative value. So the speed will be 5, that means here. This one will be 5. So we just have to solve this question with Pythagoras theorem. So P equals to positive negative square root 5 squared minus 4 squared. So since it is negative value, so we know that answer should be negative 3. So next question, find the direction of boat A that move with this velocity. Correct to nearest degree. So now we know the velocity of A should be 4 and negative 3. We want to find the direction. Look at this. This is actually the direction. So to find the direction, we'll do this. This is north, right? We start from the center. So 4 units to the right here, and 3 units to downwards. So that means this is our direction. You have to note that for direction, it's not the same as the trigonometry at sugar to coffee. No, 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 it's not the same. For this one, for trigo, we'll count the angle from here, right? We'll count like this, but for direction, we'll count from north. So from this line to here. So now we want to find what is the angle here. So we can use tangent. So tangent theta equals to 3 over 4. Theta will be equal to 36.87. So this is the angle here. This is theta, right? So we want the direction from here to here. That means we have to add with plus 90 degree. It will be 126.87. So this is our direction. And remember that we have to correct our answer to the nearest degree. So that means this should be 127 degree. So this will be our answer. So now question C. Find the time taken in minutes when boat A meet with boat B, hence find the position vector when they meet. So now, when boat A meet with boat B, that means they are at the same point, right? They're at the same place since they meet together. So that means the position vector of A and B will be the same since they are at the same point when they meet, right? So position vector of A will be equals to position vector of B. They're at the same place. But then you have to note that the boat A and boat B, they are moving. They start moving at the same time. That means here is our boat A, and then boat A will start to move, and then boat B will start to move as well. So that means the position vector keep changing. So the new position vector of A will be, this is the initial point where they start to move. And then, so do you still remember this? So now we want to find the new position vector of boat A. So this is the starting point. And then we want to find, after T minutes, how far the boat A move. Okay, so how far, that means it should be distance. So since we want to find distance, then we cover distance. So that means distance equal to time multiplied by speed. So time, I just put T minutes. And then the speed of A will be this, okay, 4 and negative 3. So the same thing goes to board B. The starting point of board B will be negative Q and negative 2. And then after 2 minutes with the velocity 3, negative 1, but this is how far board B moves. Okay, so we can simplify this. Negative 2 plus 4t and then 8 minus... Okay, so now we want to find the time when they meet. So since they start at the same time, so the time should be the same for board A and board B when they meet. So we just have to compare either this first line or the second line. But here, of course, we will compare the second line. Why? Because the first line, we got another variables here, so we can't find what is t, right? So we compare the second line, equal to negative 2, negative t, and then 2t equal to 10, and then t will be 5 minutes. Okay, so we want the answer in minutes, right? So you just look at the velocity here, it is meter per minute, so we don't have to do any conversion of unit. Okay, so this is the first answer. Now we want to find the position vector when they meet. So again, when they meet, they are at the same place, so both A and both B will have same position vector. So I just substitute t equal to 5 into this position vector. Negative 2 plus 4 times 5, so we will get 18, negative 7. So this is our position vector. So next question. So for the rest of the questions, all of them are from trial 2023. Okay, so now diagram 9 shows the straight line this and then intersect with the curve this at point A. So find the coordinate of A. This is quite simple, you just have to use the simultaneous equation. So I directly show you my steps, so you may just refer to it. And since point A is at the negative region of X, A should have negative X value. So it shouldn't be 6, 12, instead it should be negative 2 and 4. So now look at B, the area of shaded region P. So we want to find this area, right? So now I write down this one, since A is negative 2 and 4, so that means here should be negative 2. And then here should be 4. And then for this straight line, from the equation, we can know that the y-intercept is 6 and the x-intercept is negative 6, right? Just look at here, 6 and negative 6. Okay, so to find area of P, I can use the area of this triangle, I name it as A, plus the area of this. This is the area under the curve, right? I name it as B. So area of P equals to A plus B. So look at A is triangle, so here the bottom and the height should be 4 as well. So that means it's half times 4 times 4. And then plus the area of B is the area under this curve about the x-axis, right? So integrate, so look at this, what is the limit? Here is 0 and here is negative 2. So it should be from 0 to negative 2. And the equation of a curve is this. Since we want to find the area under the curve about the x-axis, so we have to do this. Y equals to x squared. So we put this into here. So for A, I will get 8. And then for B here, I can take out 1 over 4 and then integrate 0 dx. Okay, so continue to do the integration, substitute the limit, so I will get the answer 44 over 3. So for answer checking, I will try to think, can we use other method to find out the P area and compare whether the answer is the same? If they are the same, then most probably our answer is correct. So just now we used the area of the triangle plus the area under the curve about the x-axis, and we plus A and B together. So now I try to do it the other way around, which is, can you see this is a trapezium? So we can use the area of this trapezium minus the Q area. Then we will get P. Okay? So how to find the area of Q? It is area under the curve about the y-axis. So we have to find out limit. Here is 4. And so what is the value here? Coordinate is 0 and 1. Just have to substitute this into the curve equation and then you will get that x is equal to 3. Okay, so we already got the limit, so we can do the integration, find out the area of Q. So I respect your time, so I directly show you the answer checking here. I already did it for you. This is my working. In the end, we will find out the answer is the same. That means our answer is correct. So next question. In a basket, 84% of durians are in good condition. If a sample of 8 durians are chosen at random, for the probability that... Okay, so from here, we can know that the P should be 0.84 and n should be 8. So this is a binomial distribution question. Okay, so We want to find the probability that exactly 6 durians are in good condition. Okay, so we just have to find what is the probability. What is the formula for this binomial distribution? It's actually 8cx times 0.84x times 1 minus 0.84 power 8 minus x. So it's actually 8 minus x. So this is the formula that we're going to use for this question. So to save your time during the exam, we don't have to key in this formula over and over again for different questions. No, we just have to key in once in your calculator. And then afterwards, we just have to key in different x values and we will directly get the answer. So it will save a lot of the time. So this is how we can do that. Okay, so 8cx. So how can we get the x here? It's actually alpha and this, okay? And then times 0.84 power of x, and then times 0.16 power of 8 minus x. So we have to double check the equation to make sure that we key in it correctly. So now we can just press calculate to key in different x value. For example, x equal to 1, and calculate x equal to 2, calculate x equal to 3, that is. Okay, so for the first question, we want x equal to 6, right? So just calculate x equal to 6 and we will get our answer. So the first question is actually 8c6, 0.84. So we just have to key in the x value, which is 6, into your calculator and we will directly get the answer, right? 0.2518. Okay, so this is the answer. And the second question, at most 7 durians are in good condition. At most, that means I want the probability x is less than or equal to 7. That means I want the probability from x equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So to make our life easier, I will do this instead. 1 minus px more than 7 minus the x value that is more than 7 will be x is equal to 8. Okay, so equals to 1 minus, you just have to key in 8 into your calculator and you will get the values. But you still have to write down the step out, of course. So we'll get the answer 1 minus 0.2479, and then this will be your final answer. So for the second question, we want to find this, right? You can just use calculator for answer checking. That means you just have to key in this x value and then you'll get this much x value in a short period of time very quickly. And then you just sum them together and you will get that this is your final answer. It is actually the same as this. It might be a little bit different at the back here, the 5 and the 1, because for each of the x values here, I round up the values, but then they're actually the same. So this is for your answer checking. So last question, find the range of value of x if y is less than 10 and this. So since y is less than 10, I can modify this equation so that only y is at the left hand side and the rest just put it at the back. So here will be 3y equals to 4x plus 2x squared, and I will get this. So y is equal to this, and then y is less than 10. That means this whole thing is actually less than 10. Alright, remember to simplify your equation and then factorize. Okay, so we can get this. This is negative 5, this is 3. So we want less than 0, that means it's the bottom part. So that means our answer, the range of x should be negative 5 less than x less than 3. So for answer checking, we just have to see when x is in this range, do we get y value that is in this range? If yes, then our answer is correct. So again, key in this equation into your calculator and key in different x value to find what is the y value. So I will choose the x values that is very close to 3 and very close to negative 5, but the values are in the range. Okay, so for example, when it is very close to negative 5, that means I can choose when x is equal to negative 4.999. So you just key in this x value into your calculator and then we will get our y value equals to 9.99. You see 9.99 is actually less than 10. That means our y value is less than 10. So it satisfies this range given in the question. So now I substitute the second value of x, which is 2.9999. It's very close to 3, but it's not. So we'll get the y value, which is 9.999. You see, it is still less than 10. So it's still in this range. So from here, we can know that most probably our answer is correct. But if you want to further prove that you are correct, that's cool. Then we just have to key in an x value that slightly falls outside the range. For example, 3.0001. Our y value will be 10.00053. This is actually more than 10. That means this does not satisfy this. So this further proves that we are correct. So again, remember to check out the first part and the second part of my math series, especially the second part. First, don't forget to smash the like button below and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'm the Sun. Have a nice day.